Hi, good morning to everyone. I welcome back to see on the parts of speech. Today in this class, I will teach you verb. What is verb? Verb is an action done by the subject. Verb is the most important parts of all the 8 parts. You know, there is no sentence in the English without using verb. So simply says, verb is the hero of the English language and the heart of the English language. We start with types of verbs: state and action, main and auxiliary, regular and irregular modals. First you see state and action. What is state? State is a situation. Action denotes physical activity. Here an example. Sometimes it is called as stating and dynamic, but both are same meaning. State means, already I told, situation. Here, I have a large family. Have is a state verb, but have do not any physical activity. Action verb is a physical activity. Here, we are stating. Here, state and stating. What are the difference between of these two sentences? First, I have a large family. Already I told have is a state verb. Have is not a physical activity. Here, Sita likes ice cream. Is Sita likes doing any physical activity? No. So, likes is a just to give information. One more thing, state verbs cannot be used in ing. State verb cannot be used in ing, that is continuous form. Then what is action? Already I told, action verb is a physical activity like kick, eat, sit, run, etc. Here we are eating. Then are you sitting? Eat and sitting are the main verbs. So, that is physical activity. So, we can use ing. We write, I am having a large family. Is it correct? Sita is liking ice cream. That is not correct, because have and like are also state verbs. We cannot use it ing. But eat and sit are also physical activity, so we can use ing. Can you understand? Then let's go on main and auxiliary verbs. What is main verb and what is auxiliary verb? Main verbs like kick, run, sit, etc. Auxiliary verbs like am, is, are, was, were. Here, auxiliary verbs sometimes it's called as verb, helping verbs. Helping verbs can help main verbs. For example, I am working now. Here, what are the two parts of verbs here? Am and working. Am is the auxiliary verb. Working is the main verb. And then to form a negative. I am not working now. Here not is a negative. Then are you working here? To form a question form. Here all these three sentences used be verbs. So, helping verbs like be. Be is used am and are. Sometimes we use he is working now and he is not working. They are working. They are not working. So some use like be verbs. Then move to have. I have visited Delhi 4 times. I visited Delhi last year. Can you tell me what is the purpose of have is used here? First you see, I visited Delhi last year. Why do not use have? Because last year tell us the single experiences. But the first sentence, I have visited Delhi 4 times, that is denotes, 4 times denotes long experience. So we have used have. Okay. Then I have a car. Here, have denotes both. You see, first I have visited Delhi. I have visited Delhi 4 times. And I have a car. This is main verbs have. But first sentence have is the auxiliary verbs and the second one is main verbs. Then third type is regular and irregular. What is the difference between regular and irregular? The last letter in all verbs, last letter ending ed, it indicates simple past tense. It is called as regular verbs. They do not end in ed in the simple past tense. Indicates simple past tense, that is called irregular verbs. Here some example regular verbs like, liked, play, played, kick, kicked, jump, jumped, love, loved. All comes under regular verb. Then irregular, eat, ate, sit, sat, catch, cut, run, ran, bite, but. This sentence change the spelling also. Here E-A-T-8, then change to A-T-E. So they change the spelling also. Here an example, my father liked his car. Here the main verb is like. The end in ed. So it indicates simple past tense. Like is present tense, liked is simple past tense. So that is called regular verb. The second one, my father sold his car. This sentence main verb is sold, but not ending ed. It indicates, but indicates a simple past tense. So that is irregular verb. Second one, the last one, models. We have already studied 24 auxiliaries. Out of 11 auxiliary verbs, am, is, are, was, were, do, does, did, have, has, had. 11 auxiliary verbs. 13 are modals. 10 simple modals and 3 are semi modals. 10 modals like can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, must, ought. What is modals? Modal is a verb. It's a verb is used to before another verb. It expresses meaning, that is possible, not certain, necessity, duty. It expresses some meanings. Like some example, can, that is possible. It shows ability, a request. For example, can I take a cup of coffee? I can speak 5 languages. Can I swim? That is all comes under can. Could, past form of can. That is also possible. It shows also the same as can. Polite request and ability. I could speak English. Could I talk to Mr. Kannan? Then may. That is not certain. That means not definitely. For example, It will rain. That is definitely. But it may be rain. That is not definitely. That is certain, not certain. Here, it shows permissions, possibility, wishes. Example like possibility, it may rain. It may be rain. Wishes, may God bless you. Permission, may I come in, sir? So all comes under may, might. Past form of may. It is less possible. It might rain today. Then shall. Shall, it is used future plan. Shall and will use future plan. It is a suggestion. Shall I go this way? Shall I take this pen? That is commander shall. Okay. Should past form of shall. Should past form of shall. It is an application. It shows duty. You should obey the rules. You should obey the parents. You should obey your elders. That is commander should. Will. Already I told shall and will come used in future plan. Certainty. For example, Kannan will come from London next week. Here, next week is future. So, it is used will. Then would. Would. Past form of will. It can use polite request. For example, would you lend me your camera? Okay. Then must. Must is a compulsory. It is used. Compulsory like you read. You must read newspapers daily because it improves your vocabulary. So must. So compulsory. The last one, art. Art is a desirable. It is also duty. You ought to submit your application on time. So all are comes 10 modals like can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, must, ought. Okay, students. I hope you are all understand in this part verbs. Now, students, we have seen basic grammar. Verb. I give some homework related with the types of verbs like state and action, main and auxiliary, regular and irregular modals. Here, first I dash thus gave. I called her because I dash to talk. Third one I dash is movies. Fourth one I dash a student. Fifth one we dash in Jyoti High Secondary School. Sixth one, I dash, speak in 5 languages. The seventh one, you dash to obey parents. And write any 3 sentences about certain verbs and their future plan. The ninth one, dash, I carry your bag. The last one, I dash, a pen yesterday. All are related with 4 types of grammar. You have finished homework and sent it in your class teacher. Until bye from your class teacher, Jyoti Ma'am. Thank you.